Bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, SN2. The SN2 reaction is a one-step process which involves the formation of activated complex at transition step. In SN2 reaction, the nucleophile will attack from the back side of the electrophilic carbon, that is from the side directly opposite bonded to the halogen atom. So as you can see here, the nucleophile will not attack from the front because it is blocked by the halogen. So what will happen? The nucleophile will attack from the back side. The drawing for SN2 reaction must be drawn in 3D. So what will happen in SN2 reaction? Okay, the nucleophile will attack the electrophilic carbon from the backside, which is directly opposite to the halogen. So this attack will form what we call as a transition step, in which during this transition step, bond is formed between the nucleophile and the carbon, and the bond is breaking between the carbon and also the halogen. The SN2 reaction involves the attack of the nucleophile from the back. Therefore, it is best to use a less steric bulky haloalkanes. Therefore, primary carbocation work best with this. So meaning to say, we prefer primary or methyl haloalkane. We also need to use strong nucleophile in order to repel the leaving group away from the haloalkanes. So the red determining step involves two species, haloalkanes and also nucleophile. Therefore, red is equal to concentration Rx times concentration nucleophile. It is a second order reaction. And please take note that the SN2 reaction always lead to the inversion of configuration. Mari kita tengok example 3, reaction of ethyl bromide with aqueous sodium hydroxide. So ini adalah reaction equation dia, dan kita gunakan di sana strong nucleophile sebab OH2 attach dengan metal. So what will happen? Okay, untuk kita tulis SN2 reaction ini, nucleophile akan attack daripada belakang. Okay, lepas tu BR akan keluarlah. Tindak balas ini adalah slow, menghasilkan satu transition state yang mana di sini bond is formed dan di sini pula bond is breaking. Tindak balas ini fast untuk menghasilkan alkohol dan juga ion bromide. So kalau kita lihat reactant dengan produk, dia mesti ada inversion of configuration. Next, mari kita tengok pula daripada relative reactivities of SN2 reaction. So, reactivity of SN2 reaction depends on the size of the groups attached to the CX atom that being attacked. So, relative reactivities of haloalkanes in an SN2 reaction is opposite to SN1. So, meaning to say, untuk SN2 punya reaction, dia prefer methyl ataupun primary haloalkane. Kenapa? This is because the reaction will be fast when the groups are small and will slow when larger groups are attached. So, the presence of bulky alkyl groups will prevent the nucleophilic attack. So kalau macam yang ini, dia cuma ada small groups. Dia methyl bromide small groups. SN2 favor lah, SN2 suka. Yang macam begini, dia cuma ada satu bulky group di situ. Masih lagi boleh. Tapi kalau yang ini, dia ada dua bulky group. Dan yang ini, dia ada tiga bulky group. So nucleophile tidak boleh attack daripada belakang. So bila nucleophile tidak boleh attack daripada belakang, SN2 reaction itu tidak boleh berlaku. So, itu sebabnya SN2 reaction dia prefer methyl dan juga primary haloalkane. SN2 reactions are governed mainly by steric factors ataupun steric effect. Therefore, the more the alkyl groups connected to the reacting carbon, the slower the reaction. Carbon must not be sterically hindered. Tertiary halides do not react via SN2 mechanism disebabkan oleh steric hindrance. So, apa tu steric hindrance? Steric hindrance is the special arrangement of the groups near the reacting site hinders ataupun retards merencatkan suatu tindak balas. Large groups can often hinder the formation. Manakala steric effect is an effect of on relative rates caused by the space filling properties of those parts of a molecule attached at or near to the reacting sites. Mari kita tengok steric effect dengan lebih mendalam. So kalau kita tengok di situ, kita ada ethyl bromide, isopropyl bromide dan juga tert-butyl bromide. So untuk ethyl bromide, attack is easy. Okay, tapi untuk isopropyl bromide, attack is possible. Tapi untuk tert-butyl bromide, attack is impossible sebab dia punya steric effect sangat besar. Dia ada large bulky group di situ. Bukan semua primary haloalkanes boleh undergo SN2 reaction. Kalau primary haloalkanes itu dia ada large alkyl group, dia tidak akan undergo SN2 reaction sebab dia ada steric hindrance. So what will happen kalau dalam case ini, dia tidak boleh attack dari belakang. Okay, sebab ada bulky group di situ. Jadi what will happen, this type of haloalkanes will undergo SN1 reaction. So kamu boleh prefer dalam contoh yang saya tunjukkan di dalam video sebelum ini.